What's up, guys? FSC Trucking. Well, we loaded our Striker. It's a little 1500, and it's going to State College, Pennsylvania. Our lights on, strobes. We're ready to go. We are going to my shop first. I'm going to deliver this. We're going to run over the weekend and deliver it Monday. That's the plan. It's been a little while since we've done a Striker, isn't it? Matter of fact, last one I did was the one that went to Georgia. That's the last one that I brought. Recently with that Ford CL9000, so it's good. Gonna be back trucking, get some more trucking vlogs done. It's kind of hard to tell who likes what better, the trucking vlogs or the working and shop vlogs. All of a sudden that's kind of come up and been better, and I've been trying to focus on the Ford. Questions regarding the direction of the views, the direction I've been taking as far as building this truck, working with the Ford and the 352 Peterbilt. And it's funny, I feel like I've addressed those things.
I got radio down.
But admittedly, not everybody sees every video I put out.
Thank you.
regarding the direction of the build when it comes to the Ford and the Peterbilt, the 352 Peterbilt. First off, the Peterbilt 352 is not being junked. I'm not getting rid of it. I've been spending all that time to repo the damn thing. I sure as hell ain't getting rid of it. However, the frame is absolute junk. It was a single axle truck. Somebody put a rear cutoff on it to make it a dual axle truck. And at that point, that frame never really was any good. It was thinner than the original, believe it or not. And it was cracked. When I took the fifth wheel off, it was cracked. So that frame was garbage and had to be gone. But I do want the axles out of it. Those are going into Ford. Ford is going to maintain its Dayton wheels. No, they're not split rims, and rims are still available for those. It's just a different type of hub. There's nothing wrong with them. Personally, I don't understand, if you're running vintage equipment like I do, why would everybody insist on modernizing it? It worked for all those years, leave it alone. In my view, it worked for all those years, leave well enough alone. It's expensive enough to build these trucks. Why do we have to complicate them even more? But in the order of what I'm planning on building and when and how, the order's gonna be the Ford's gonna get done first. Then I'll worry about the Peterbilt. And again, the Peterbilt's gonna get an all new frame, just like the Ford will. So right now, the video that got released as of now, the time of filming this, was me raising the cab of the Ford. And I'm responding to comments on that. Somebody said I shouldn't have lifted the cab like I did, quote, leave it to the professionals. Okay, this isn't 1983. Where do I find the professional to raise a cab without lift cylinders? Where do I find the professional that works on Ford cab owners? My Ford dealer? Or the Peterbilt dealer? That hasn't seen a cab over in 20 years. See the problem? You have to try your best to do all this crap yourself and figure it out and muddle through it. Does everything work perfectly? No, of course not. I am very aggravated at myself that I thought pulling the truck out the way I did with the lifting hook rather than the forks would have worked better. It didn't. Stabbed a hole in the back of the engine compartment of the Ford, and I'm not happy about it, but it can be fixed or patched or maybe even modified. But time will tell. Can't make an omelet without breaking eggs, and that's an egg I broke, I guess. Is what it is. Learn and move on. For me, that Ford retain its originality so it's recognizable as to what it always used to be. As of right now, I have made no determination on what I'm going to do with the engine. I'm leaning towards rebuilding the one I have because it's what came with it, rather than acquire a whole nother engine for a whole nother boatload of money. I'll just stick with what I got and run with it. That truck will not be the heavy haul truck, but I do think I'm going to order a thicker frame. But the basic idea of the build is I'm going to put it together in the same manner in which I took it apart. It'll get a whole new frame. Front axle, rear axles, well, the front axle, keep it the same. Put new rear axles under it. and then I'll put the cab back on it with the same equipment, the very same way I took it off. Up all the way and then put the engine and transmission back into it. It's gonna take a lot of time, not this fast. A lot of comments about the help that I did not have. Well, Terry had obligations that he couldn't get out of. I'm not gonna get it personally, but he had obligations that he a major part of his life, and I'm going to take all the time he needed. It was important for that weekend for him to not be at my shop. Maggie had other things going on. I didn't have any welding jobs for her, but I sure could use the help. But she had other obligations as well that she was handling. Again, he's a part-time job. Dave, unfortunately, I believe he quit only because he's got sickness in the family he has to deal with. Having a part-time job, it just wouldn't be helpful for him with the family obligations he has with someone that's in his family that recently got sick. So that's that. So I gotta hire more help. That's the way it goes.
About 4,000 to 5,000 miles on them. They're done. They're time to go.